Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. A hypothesis is a statement that can be tested by scientific research. If you want to test a relationship between two or more things, you need to write hypotheses before you start your experiment or data collection. In this tutorial, we discuss about the term hypothesis. What is hypothesis? Why we use hypothesis in research and types of hypothesis. Let's start.
First, we need to understand the term. Hypothesis. What is hypothesis? A hypothesis states your predictions about what your research will find. It is a tentative answer to your research question that has not yet been tested. For some research projects, you might have to write several hypotheses that address different aspects of your research question. A hypothesis is not just a guess, it should be based on existing theories and knowledge. It also has to be testable, which means you can support or refute it through scientific research methods, such as experiments, observations, and statistical analysis of data.
Variables in hypotheses. Hypotheses propose a relationship between two or more variables. An independent variable is something the researcher changes or controls. A dependent variable is something the researcher observes and measures.
Why we use hypothesis in research. The purpose of a hypothesis is to find the answer to a question. A formalized hypothesis will force us to think about what results we should look for in an experiment. The outcome is called the dependent variable. Research hypothesis can be classified 7 categories. 1. Simple hypothesis. It shows a relationship between one dependent variable and a single independent variable. For example, if you eat more vegetables, you will lose weight faster. Here, eating more vegetables is an independent variable, while losing weight is the dependent variable. 2. Complex hypothesis. It shows the relationship between two or more dependent variables and two or more independent variables. Eating more vegetables and fruits leads to weight loss, glowing skin, reduces the risk of many diseases such as heart disease, high blood pressure, and some cancers. 3. Directional hypothesis. It shows how a researcher is intellectual and committed to a particular outcome. The relationship between the variables can also predict its nature. For example, children aged 4 years eating proper food over a 5-year period are having higher IQ levels than children not having a proper meal. This shows the effect and direction of effect. 4. Non-directional hypothesis. It is used when there is no theory involved. It is a statement that a relationship exists between two variables, without predicting the exact nature, direction, of the relationship. 5. Null hypothesis. It provides the statement which is contrary to the hypothesis. It's a negative statement, and there is no relationship between independent and dependent variables. The symbol is denoted by HO. 6. Associative and causal hypothesis. Associative hypothesis occurs when there is a change in one variable resulting in a change in the other variable. Whereas, causal hypothesis proposes a cause and effect interaction between two or more variables. 7. Alternative hypothesis. It is stated that there is a relationship between two variables of the study and that results are significant to the research topic.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.